In the beginning there was nothing. The universe consisted of a great chaotic ocean. And Benben emerged amid this primal chaos. Benben was a huge pyramidal mound. There was a lotus flower with Benben, and this, when it blossomed, brought the god Ra to the world, and light came with him. Ra by himself generated the first generations of gods. Shu, the god of the air, and Tefnut, the goddess of rain, were born. The universe was enwrapped by a vast mass of primordial waters. Shu and Tefnut plunged into the waters to explore its immensity. Ra felt afflicted after realizing that their children were taking a long time to return, and fearing never seeing them again, he sent his best messenger to find them. Shu and Tefnut returned safe and sound, and Ra's joy was so immense that human beings were born from his tears. After returning, their children generated in turn Geb, the god of the earth, and Nut, the goddess of the sky, and thus the sky and the earth were created. The great god Ra sovereignly ruled the universe power, and he was awarded the title of the first pharaoh. The god gifted Egypt with several sacred animals like the ox and the lion, but his greatest offering was the creation of the Nile River. Around its shores, men would edify a civilization glorifying the gods. But Ra had a premonition that his grandchildren would give birth to a new generation of gods who would put an end to his reign. And so the great god forbade the sky and the earth to have any offspring whatsoever. But Nut and Geb disobeyed and gave rise to a powerful offspring, Isis, Neft, Seth, and Osiris. They dethroned Ra, and Osiris started to reign over the world. But the new god's throne was not safe, because his brother Seth was eager to take all power for himself. And so the saga of Egyptian gods began.